Maybe some of us think that the global internet as we feel today is transmitted by satellite. But believe it or not, almost 80% more internet data transmission is currently connected on land and at sea. The problem at that time was the increasing demand for data transfer speeds and the demand for internet access worldwide. However, since the invention of fiber optic technology, where data transmission can run through light transmission, telecommunications experts have begun to think about ways to connect one land to another through the ocean. Maybe planting fiber optic cable in the ground is not a heavy burden. But laying cables on the seabed requires more complicated scientific and engineering calculations. Therefore, special cables and vessels are needed to pull it. The optical cable core structure is made of glass to transmit data at a rate of tens of terabits per second. Even today, Microsoft and Facebook are funding the installation of an optical cable between the coast of Virginia, the United States, to Bilbao, Spain, which can reach data transmission speeds of up to 160 terabits per second. The data transmission speed is equal to 16 million times the data transmission speed of home internet, or equivalent to streaming 71 million high-definition videos at the same time. Optical cables planted under the sea are 3 to 4 inches in size, with cable structures that have been designed in such a way, such as their strength against earthquakes, humidity, water pressure, mountain eruptions, shark bites, and the contours of the ocean floor. Although the diameter of the cable looks large, the core through which internet data passes is only the thickness of a human hair. Therefore, optical fiber is wrapped in several layers with its mechanical function and strength. As for the layers of fiber optic cables planted under the sea, the first is the cable core. The next layer is petroleum gel, which functions to keep the optical fiber in place due to bending or pulling. After that, there is a layer of copper tube that serves for protection and also provides power. Where power is needed to amplify the signal every 50 miles by connecting it to a repeater. In the next layer, there is polycarbonate, aluminum water barrier, thick steel cable, Miller tape, and tar coating. In this case, the process of laying cables in the ocean becomes important. The cable laying process is carried out by special trawlers that have the ability to carry optical cable reels with all the necessary equipment and can dock in shallow waters around the coast. A survey of the depth and condition of the ocean soil will be carried out along the cable laying route. The next process is loading the cable to the ship, where large reels of cable will be loaded on the hull slowly and very carefully. Loading times can be up to 1 month, with crew working 12-hour shifts. The ship will dock as close to the shore as possible to begin pulling the cable from the mainland. Equipment in the form of an underwater pirate machine was lowered for the task of burying the cable. The ship will slowly leave the shore, with the plow starting to plant the cable according to the designated path. The burial of the cable is not carried out too deep, in accordance with the conditions of soil density and coastal traffic, so that it is safe from the anchors of other boats that are anchored. Some may ask, how to connect a fiber optic cable that breaks in the middle of the sea? In addition to natural disasters and ship anchors, underwater cable breaks often occur due to shark bites. Humans cannot dive in the sea that is too deep. Cable repair is carried out by pulling the broken cable using special anchors. Then do the connection on the ship and put back into position. Actually, submarine cables have existed since 170 years ago. In 1858, the first transatlantic telegraph cable, covered with tar and Indian rubber, was laid in the ocean between Ireland and the Canadian province of Newfoundland. It caused a major change in the communication time of the transatlantic shipping company, from sending messages in a week to a matter of minutes. However, the problem at that time was that the demand for telegraph delivery was too large, causing the transmission speed to slow down. By increasing the electric current for the purpose of increasing the speed of transmission, it turns out that Several long-range submarine cable designs were introduced in 1865 and an underwater repeater to amplify signals was introduced in 1956. With the increase in internet subscribers, the need for fast connections, bandwidth capacity, and low latency has become the impetus for several large companies to build new cables under the sea. Like Facebook, Microsoft, Amazon, Alphabet, and Apple all have a big role in the density of internet data traffic in the world. On the other hand, data traffic via satellite also gets special attention because this technology allows remote areas such as forests, mountains, and small islands that are not covered by cable to connect to the global internet network.